First thing up, when we're talking about smart contracts, realize that a smart contract is the same as whether a koala bear is to a bear. So it's basically not really a bear, it has something to do with it, just like a smart contract is not really smart and it has something to do with a contract. So what actually is a smart contract? Remember, it's programmable data, so we can program it into a certain route, which means that a smart contract is a decision tree, a type of decision tree. So if this happens, then I go into that direction, or if this happens, then I go into that direction. So let me explain it. You remember this card, my employee card of The Hague University. I checked in, so my status went from offline to online. My digital identity is connected. It gives me proof of ownerships and it gives me authority, in this case, authority to enable a smart contract. So imagine this being a smart contract. A smart contract always needs input. I'm going to give it input right now. So I'm going to determine the route that's automatically happening. In other words, I'm selecting hot water, input, a cup, and then check. And now I'm going to give it my private key. In other words, I'm going to authorize this transaction with my private key. It checks, it automatically fills this cup based on the input I gave it. In other words, based on the variables, a smart contract runs into a certain direction. So let me give another example. So for example, if you have a soccer match where party A plays against party B and you want to bet on the outcome. In current world, you will need to go to something like Unibet, where you actually need to give your money, your funds to Unibet, and Unibet will seek your pair, and then you're going to bet against your pair, but Unibet is still in the middle. So Unibet has the three main categories. They can falsify, they can exclude people, they can run with your money, etc. They ask a fee, it will take time. So why not erase Unibet and not just make a smart contract between? So person A sends money into the smart contract, person B sends money into the smart contract, and then the match is about to be played. So based on the output of the match, so based on the final score of the match, which is a variable input for the smart contract, so that's the same thing as me pressing buttons, the contract will start doing things. So just as I randomly select here and give it input, the outcome of a soccer match also gives it input, only in another way. So the soccer match, let's say, football club Real Madrid wins, Barcelona wins, and in the end, Barcelona wins. So the smart contract gets input, the end of the game, for example, from UEFA.com or Barcelona.com, and then the contract checks, okay, did I receive money? Yes. Did I receive money? Yes. Did Barcelona win? Okay, then I will send money to this entity. Did Real Madrid win? I will send money to this entity. If it's a tie, I will send the money back. You will see it in advance what it will do, because it's transparent, it's open, and you can actually determine the route in advance, so you know beforehand that if this person doesn't want to pay up, his money is locked in the contract. So if you have a friend and you want to bet and that friend never pays up, just make a smart contract and he or she can't back out of it. So in this case, this entity is happy, Barcelona wins, not much cost. And more importantly, it's on a decentralized ledger, so your data is protected, less transaction cost, you see where I'm going, right? So we're building upon this infrastructure with new tools that automatically run itself without the intervention of a human being, just as I just made this cup of tea without the intervention of a human being, just as we can play on sport games without human intervention, eventually automating the world, creating new structural societies, like for example, decentralized autonomous organizations. Organizations that run on the very properties of a public blockchain in an automated way, basically see it as an application on a decentralized world. I think for now, hopefully you understand what a smart contract is. Just in case, we will give you one or two very good other videos explaining it way better than I just did. Really grasp these concepts. Remember, a smart contract is nothing more than an automated decision tree that will run itself based on the code that we gave it. So programmable data in economic infrastructure 2.0. See you in next course. I will drink my tea.